Although the Big Bang Theory remains the dominant cosmological narrative, championed in academia, textbooks and pop science alike, there are growing reasons to question this secular miracle. As we peel back its layers, we discover a theory upheld less by direct observation than by speculative interpretation, exotic hypotheticals and institutional inertia. Quote, they deride the creationists, yet in the same breath promote the Big Bang, end quote, Walt Thornhill. Ironically, the term Big Bang itself was coined not by a supporter but a critic, Fred Hoyle, the brilliant astrophysicist and former Royal Astronomer. In a 1950 BBC broadcast, Hoyle sarcastically referred to the theory as this Big Bang idea, intending mockery, not endorsement. The label stuck, but Hoyle's deeper concern was more serious. Quote, this Big Bang idea seemed to me to be unsatisfactory, even before detailed examination showed that it leads to serious difficulties. End quote. From the sublime to the ridiculous. The Big Bang was born from the musings of Georges Lemaître, a Belgian priest and mathematician who sought to reconcile science and theology. His primeval atom was less physical hypothesis than a metaphysical one, creation ex nihilo with mathematical window dressing. Quote, this is the most beautiful and satisfactory explanation of creation to which I have ever listened, end quote, Albert Einstein. Lemaître's idea found unlikely allies in Einstein and later in Pope Pius XII, who heralded the theory as aligning with biblical creation. Thus the Big Bang gained not only scientific but spiritual capital, allowing it to sidestep less speculative models like Hoyle's steady state. Hannes Alfvén, the father of plasma physics and pioneer of plasma cosmology, was blunt in his appraisal. Quote, I was there when Lemaître first proposed this theory. He said in private that it was a way to reconcile science with St. Thomas Aquinas' theological dictum of creation out of nothing. There is no rational reason to doubt that the universe has existed indefinitely for an infinite time. It is only myth that attempts to say how the universe came to be either 4,000 or 20 billion years ago. End quote. Despite its questionable origins, skepticism towards the Big Bang is often treated as scientific heresy. But where is the actual data? One, science frequently emphasizes its foundation in empiricism, so let's examine the evidence. Two pillars are routinely cited as definitive proof, redshift and the cosmic microwave background radiation. These are presented as smoking guns, yet growing challenges have raised serious questions about their interpretation. The CMB, a sacred relic? Discovery of cosmic microwave background radiation by Penzias and Wilson in 1965 is hailed as decisive proof of the Big Bang, although the reality is more nuanced. Arno Penzias himself admitted, quote, the best data we have are exactly what I would have predicted had I nothing to go on but the five books of Moses, end quote. So was the CMB evidence for physics or theology? More concerning is the post-discovery groupthink that followed. As astrophysicist Jeffrey Burbidge warns, quote, all of the work on the CMB has been carried on by observers who are absolutely convinced that whatever they find, they are quite sure where it came from. This has led to a bandwagon so overwhelming that alternative interpretations of the data are hardly ever mentioned, never taught or discussed at meetings, or referred to in textbooks. End quote. Instead of testing models, the field began to retrofit anomalies, patching the theory with increasingly exotic scaffolding. It's worth noting that the background temperature of space was predicted by several prominent scientists prior to the discovery of the CMB and without relying on an expanding universe. Their estimates were, in many cases, significantly more accurate than those proposed by early Big Bang models. A peer-reviewed paper detailing this overlooked history states, quote, in this paper we show that other models of a universe in dynamical equilibrium without expansion had predicted this temperature prior to Gamow. Moreover, we show that Gamow's own predictions were worse than these previous ones, end quote. This challenges the widely held narrative that the CMB is a unique and decisive confirmation of the Big Bang. In fact, alternative interpretations exist, including, but not limited to, those offered by plasma cosmology. As plasma physicist Eric Lerner of LPP Fusion puts it, quote, "The CMB is a radio fog of dense plasma filaments," end quote. Lerner is the author of The Big Bang Never Happened, a best-selling book in which he anticipated several findings now being confirmed by the James Webb Space Telescope. If his model is correct, the CMB may have little or nothing to say about the age of the universe. Adding to this shift in perspective, recent studies suggest that the CMB may arise from the formation of the early luminous galaxies, rather than being a remnant of a primordial explosion. Quote, "Cosmic mystery deepens. Early galaxies may mimic the Big Bang's afterglow," end quote. That's from sciencenewstoday.org. From rarefication to reality. What mainstream cosmologists often present as proof is usually an interpretation, a theoretical model retrofitted to explain chosen observations. Alternative explanations are marginalized, and theoretical flexibility becomes theoretical contortionism. Quote, "In the beginning there was nothing, which exploded," end quote, Terry Pratchett. Edwin Hubble is a pivotal figure in modern astronomy. His most celebrated achievement came in the 1920s, when he established the existence of galaxies beyond the Milky Way, the extragalactic universe, thus overturning the prevailing belief that the Milky Way comprised the entirety of the cosmos. Known as the Hubble Law, within an expanding universe framework, it is assumed that the redshift of distant galaxies is primarily due to the Doppler effect, an increase in the wavelength of light caused by rapid recession. Mathematicians seized upon this idea, extrapolating backward to a hypothetical point of origin, which became the foundation of the Big Bang theory. However, Hubble termed his famous discovery, quote, "redshift versus apparent distance relationship." Rather than signifying that some faint galaxies are accelerating away from us, Hubble maintained that some new physics was probably involved. How often do you hear this from doctrinal scientists? Redshift revisited. The heresies of Holton Arp. Arp, a famous student of Hubble, further researched and developed his mentor's reservations about redshift. He compiled the Atlas of Peculiar Galaxies, which documents numerous galaxies that do not fit within an expanding universe. Many high redshift quasars, quasi-stellar objects, appear to be physically connected to low redshift galaxies, challenging the conventional view that redshift is a straightforward indicator of distance and velocity. Arp proposed alternative explanations, suggesting that redshifts might reflect intrinsic properties rather than solely cosmological expansion. The electric universe subscribes to Arp's thesis. Quasars are ejected from active galactic nuclei and can evolve into companion galaxies. In this case, the highly redshifted objects indicate their youthfulness. The evidence, which Arp and others began presenting several decades ago, includes, quote, "impossible connections between a high and low redshift object." This image of Stefan's quintet, for example, shows a quasar with a redshift of 10 billion light-years from Earth in front of the galaxy NGC 7319, which has a redshift of just a few hundred million light-years. Few scientists were as unorthodox and suffered for it as Holton Arp. The title of his last book, Seeing Red, is a clever play on words. A continuation of his redshift research, it also hints at his anger after being cast out by the scientific establishment. After his telescope time was withdrawn, he moved to Germany to work at the Max Planck Institute. Arp wasn't alone. Tom von Flanden, a former US Naval Observatory astronomer, noted, quote, "Big Bang cosmology has always needed a growing number of hypothetical entities, dark matter, dark energy, inflation and so on, to bridge the gap between theory and observation," end quote. JWST, a death blow? The James Webb Space Telescope was supposed to confirm the Big Bang's predictions about early galaxies. Instead, it found galaxies that were too large, too evolved, and too well formed to fit within the accepted timeline, The cosmos, it seemed, didn't get the memo. One researcher remarked, quote, "We found galaxies that should not exist." Others conceded the timeline may need rewriting again. Time, of course, is the great free variable of cosmology. It can be stretched, shrunk, or rewound as needed to rescue a failing theory. We have discussed the many issues raised by the JWST in recent episodes. More recently, the JWST has discovered another glaring anomaly. This luminous, compact, chemically evolved galaxy formed only 280 million years after the Big Bang. That's far earlier than current models allow. The anomalies are adding up. Quote, "Thanks to the Webb telescope's ultra-deep, high-definition galactic selfies, we're seeing things that should make even seasoned astrophysicists do a double take. Galaxies are popping up where they shouldn't be, cosmic timelines are bending like pretzels, and theories we've clung to for decades, like dark matter, dark energy, and the sacred story of the Big Bang's microwave afterglow, are suddenly looking wobbly. In short, we might need to rewrite the universe's autobiography," end quote. That's from the YouTube channel Cosmic Prodigy. Give us one free miracle. Terence McKenna once quipped, "Give us one free miracle and we'll explain the rest." That miracle, of course, is the sudden appearance of all matter and energy in the universe out of nothing in a single instant, blithely overriding the principle of conservation of energy, a cornerstone of modern physics. Is this really physics, or is it faith dressed in equations? Even the supposed remedy, cosmic inflation, the idea of a brief faster-than-light expansion to smooth out early irregularities, rests on no known physical mechanism. Paul Steinhardt, Nobel laureate and one of inflation's original architects, has since condemned it as, quote, "totally ad hoc and non-predictive," end quote. An open letter to closed minds. In episode 4 of this Misconception series, a number of problems with peer review were highlighted. Quote, "The primary function of peer review is gatekeeping," end quote, Britannica.com. In May 2004, several prominent scientists, plasma physicists and independent researchers signed a petition titled, quote, "An Open Letter to the Scientific Community." It was published in The New Scientist and dubbed an open letter to closed minds in some quarters. The letter highlighted several key issues, including the Big Bang's increasing dependence on hypothetical entities, the reluctance within the scientific community to explore alternative models, and the inherent bias of peer review, dominated as it is by Big Bangers. Quote, "The peer review system often creates near insurmountable hurdles against the publication of data that seems contrary to long-held beliefs," end quote, Dr. Friedman T. Freund. Sadly, little progress has been made in the last 20 years. In 2022, another controversy erupted involving the censorship of papers that challenged the prevailing Big Bang model. Quote, "Of course, if one ignores contradictory observations, one can claim to have an elegant or robust theory, but it isn't science," end quote, Holton Arp. Alternative models still standing. Alternative cosmological models may not endure the flood of mainstream funding, but they are grounded in real, testable mechanisms. Plasma cosmology, for instance, does not begin with miracles or metaphysical assumptions. It begins with plasma, the most abundant state of matter in the universe, and with electromagnetism, a force some 10 to the power of 39 times stronger than gravity. The steady-state and quasi-steady-state models proposed by Hoyle, Narlicka and Burbage may not solve every puzzle, but unlike the Big Bang, they do not rely on theological leaps or an ever-expanding catalogue of fudge factors. Today, the EU model goes further, proposing that much of cosmic structure, from the formation of galaxies to the dynamics of stars and solar systems, is better explained through plasma behavior and electromagnetic forces than by gravity alone. As physicist Anthony L. Peratt wrote, quote, "Plasmas in electric space are energetic because of electric fields, and they are generally inhomogeneous with constituent parts in motion. Plasmas in relative motion are coupled by the currents they drive in each other, and non-equilibrium plasma often consists of current-conducting filaments," end quote. The universe, it turns out, is wired. This vast electrical circuitry has only become visible with the advent of modern radio astronomy, tools unavailable when gravity-only models first solidified into dogma. The prophetic versus the evidential. At its heart, the Big Bang model is prophetic in nature. It begins with a miraculous, unobservable origin and builds layer upon layer of interpretation to preserve its canonical status. By contrast, evidential science starts with observation and constructs models that can be tested, falsified, and revised without fear or dogma. Quote, "Be suspicious of a theory if more and more hypotheses are needed to support it as new facts become available." End quote, Sir Fred Hoyle. As we look ahead, the real question isn't simply whether the Big Bang is wrong, it's whether cosmology is ready to grow up. Sometimes it takes more courage, not to mention more scientific integrity, to admit uncertainty than to cling to theories that no longer align with the evidence. Plasma and EU models may not have all the answers, but they don't pretend to. They adapt with the data, not in defiance of it. In the next episode of the Misconception series, part 11, we will look at another common question. What about dark matter and dark energy?